Typhoon Nanmadol made landfall on Japan's southwestern coast as authorities urged millions to seek shelter from the powerful storm's rain and wind. The eye of Typhoon Nanmadol hit near Kagoshima City around 7 p.m. on Sunday, the Japan Meteorological Agency said in a brief statement on its website. At least 4 million people in southern Japan were ordered to evacuate as the powerful typhoon moved towards the region, bringing strong winds and heavy rain that caused electricity blackouts and paralyzed the ground and air transportation. Nanmadol is forecast to turn east and reach Tokyo on Tuesday. The agency also warned the residents in the affected areas of flooding, landslides, as well as unprecedented levels of powerful winds and waves, and urged them to evacuate early. Local authorities have reported no major damage or injuries so far. The European Union has called for a war crimes tribunal as Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky said that new evidence of torture has been found as more bodies are exhumed from a mass burial site in a town retaken from Russian forces. Jan Lipavsky, Foreign Minister of the Czech Republic, which holds the EU's rotating presidency, said on Saturday that Russia's attack against the civilian population are unthinkable and abhorrent in the 21st century. "We must not overlook it. We stand for the punishment of all war crimes," he wrote in a message on Twitter. "I call for the speedy establishment of a special international tribunal that will prosecute the crime of aggression." The appeal follows the discovery by Ukrainian authorities of about 450 graves outside the formerly Russian-occupied city of Izium, with some of the exhumed bodies showing signs of torture. 27 people have died in a bus crash in southwest China on Sunday, the country's deadliest road accident so far this year. The accident took place on a highway in rural Guizhou province when the vehicle carrying 47 people flipped onto its side, Sandu County Police said in a statement. Emergency responders were dispatched to the scene and another 20 people were being treated for injuries. The accident happened in Kuenan Prefecture, a poor, remote and mountainous part of Guizhou, home to several ethnic minorities. Social media users angrily demanded to know why a passenger bus was travelling down a highway in the early hours when many major roads in the province have been closed to regular traffic. A massive 6.9 magnitude earthquake struck the southeastern coast of Taiwan on Sunday, bringing at least one building down in a small town and prompting Japan to issue a tsunami warning. The quake hit at 2:44 p.m. about 50 kilometers north of the city of Taitung at a depth of 10 kilometers. The initial magnitude was reported to be 7.2, which was later downgraded to 6.9. Several videos from the site of the collapsed building showed panicked residents running towards the building, which had caved in on itself and sent up thick cloud of dust. Shaking was also felt in the capital, Taipei. Taiwan's fire department said that two people were trapped in a building housing a convenience store that collapsed in Yuli, and two people had been rescued, while three people whose vehicles fell off a damaged bridge were rescued and taken to the hospital. A 6.6 magnitude quake hit the same region on Saturday, and there have been multiple tremors since.